That's going in. Hello everyone, hope you're all doing well. Gonna be doing a video today on the battle for uranium, the 13k mode in particular. Basically this is just going to be a showcase of how bad battle for uranium is and how it's just absolutely cancerous and just toxic. It's really just not a healthy or really good game mode. Basically, because the developers have just kind of thrown this in without really thinking about it, there's a bunch of balancing issues, and the balancing issues keep happening, whereby one build will be overpowered. Basically, because you bring in a power score cap, people are just going to use the most cheesy tactics and most cheesy weapons, and once one of those catches on, it really does get into the point of, if you have it, you will win, if you don't have it, you're going to lose. And this build in front of me is a very good example of that. So the developers brought in Battle for Uranium, and like I said, they didn't really think about it too hard. They didn't really proactively look into it before they implemented it. They just kind of chucked it in. And when it first came out, equalizer, fat equalizer bricks were incredibly dominant, and they just ruled the meta. And if you had them, you won. If you didn't have them, you lost. Just how it works. Then it went on to Raijins, then it went on to Yongwang cars, and now for 13k mode, you've got this, which is a Auger, Humpback, Jackie Will thing. You just brain dead charger people. Yongwangs and dogs can't do anything to you because you've got 5 meat grinders, so you do a hell of a lot of damage. And yeah, you don't need to think, you don't need to try too hard. If you have a team of these things, you're just going to win the majority of your matches based solely off of this build. And I figured I'm going to put a clip together today showing the gameplay of this, of my team running these things. My clan, I should say, running these things, a team of them. And just watch how absolutely easy it is. The only challenge you get is up against like the top clans running like really competitive build on an ideal map for them. But even then, you know. Besides that, it's just an absolute walk in the park. And it's because of the power score cap and because you just... They're too slow with implementing these changes, so if something is broken, it will be broken for like a month before they really get to changing it, and it's going to keep happening. Also, Battle for Uranium, they still haven't fixed the bug. This must be like the 7th or 8th time where they've brought this in, but they still haven't fixed the bug whereby if an enemy team leaves at the start of the match, the winning team will get deducted points because they haven't scored. So you will lose points for your team, the enemy team just running away, basically. Makes no sense, but that bug is still in the game, they still haven't fixed it. And yeah, and as for the 10k mode, basically, I just don't understand the logic behind it. All of the top players are clan players, going all the way down. You're going to have to go pretty far down this list to find someone who isn't in the top clan. And... it's just, if this mode is brought in for newer players, I don't see the appeal of it because they're not going to earn it. And it's just not very well balanced at all. So I'm sorry to ramble and go on, but yeah, this is just not a fun game mode. They might have swapped this out for Clan Wars every other week, but this is inferior to Clan Wars in majority of situations. It's just not a good mode. No one really likes it. They just do it for the uranium. And I think they should have just had it whereby you can run Clan Wars or you can run Battle for Uranium. That way all of the sweaty Clan Wars guys can run Clan Wars and get Uranium that way. And that will actually leave the leaderboards well open for newer players to get their, you know, Uranium for the first time. That's how they should have done it, but they haven't. And yeah, I figured I'd show the cheese and all of the scumminess and all of the just cancerous builds that you find in these modes at the top in this video. Tomorrow I'm going to be doing a completely different video. I've got a new build for 10k Battle for Uranium, whereby I should actually have some fun with it. It's not one of the cheesy builds. It's not one of the, you know, brain dead, just charger people builds. It's actually pretty good, and it should be decent as well, actually. It should be kind of fun to use. So tomorrow we're going to try to have actual fun in this mode. But for today, I'm going to show you the worst parts of it and just how easy this stuff is when you have the right build. So thanks for watching everyone, and I'll catch you for a video tomorrow. it does reset your progress. You can just cap out on this one. Once you own some vehicles, right? I'll just kill him quick. Thank you. fucking bunch. No, go, bro. Go, bro. Silly, can you go? Can you push up there and I'll push me? Yeah, yeah, Crip, just charge me. Just charge, I need to go to the charge. Yeah. Are you okay, please? He's gonna get hit too. I can get a shot by like 4 guys. I need help. That way, sir. I'm dead then. So, you go middle ramp, I'll go first ramp. No, you go middle ramp, I'll go first ramp. Watch out, Crip, they all see you. False drop in. Got B, not with the top. Nice. False house can be done. Left, just me out. Cap base, who was hurt? Silly, please, the way. Please don't run that toll again, dear God.
For the polar.